In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, once again, we have come around this Eucharistic table to praise and thank the Lord for all the blessings we have received from Him. And during this Mass, let us also pray for Sean Kelly, who is seriously ill. Jesus, the divine healer, touch and heal him in his mercy. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Hear what the Lord says. Arise, present your plea before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, O mountains, the plea of the Lord. Pay attention, O foundations of the earth, for the Lord has a plea against his people, and he enters into trial with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you, or how have I wearied you? Answer me, for I brought you from the land of Egypt, from the place of slavery I released you, and I sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow before God Most High? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with myriad streams of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my crime, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? You have been told, O man, what is good, and what the Lord requires of you, only to do the right and to love goodness and to walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Gather my faithful ones before me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice, and the heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you? To the upright I will show the saving power of God. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God. To the upright, I will show the saving power of God. Gospel acclamation.
Alleluia.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Some of the scribes and Pharisees said to Jesus, "Teacher, we wish to see a sign from you." He said to them in reply, "An evil and unfaithful generation seeks a sign, but no sign will be given it except the sign of Jonah the prophet. Just as Jonah was in the belly of the whale 3 days and three nights, so will the Son of Man be in the heart of the earth 3 days and three nights. At the judgment, the men of Nineveh will arise with this generation and condemn it, because they repented at the preaching of Jonah, and there is something greater than Jonah here. At the judgment, the Queen of the South will arise with this generation and condemn it, because she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And there is something greater than Solomon here." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, in English, according to a popular legend, the word sincere comes from two Latin words, sin and sia. Sin means without, sia means wax. So sin plus sia means wax without. Sincere, therefore, literally means being without wax. In ancient Greek, when art flourished, it was a common practice to repair with invisible wax any vase or statue that had, as a result of carelessness, been damaged. Sometimes, while chiseling the bust in marble, if the chisel slipped out the sculptor's hand, some edge of the statue would be chipped off. Rather than taking the trouble of making new bust, the sculptor would repair the features with wax so that the flaw could not be detected unless by very close scrutiny. However, if the client happens to be a knowledgeable person, he would carry the finished statue into the open before paying for it and examine it carefully in the sunlight. If the statue was sincere, that is, without wax, it would remain firm, or else some parts of it would drop down. Sincerity of the statue was thus examined in the presence of sunlight. Am I a sincere person without wax of deceit, malice, corruption, or guile? I need to come into the presence of the sunlight, that is Jesus, to be examined. The Gospel of the day presents an incident where the insincerity of certain group of people was exposed in the warming and bright presence of Jesus, the light of the world. Some of the scribes and the Pharisees said to Jesus, "Teacher, we wish to see a sign from you." Through St. Paul, we get to know that it was probably a characteristic of the Jews to demand signs. For Jews, demand signs, and Greeks looks for wisdom. When we scan through the pages of the Bible, we also see God himself giving many signs to his people. In the book of Genesis, we see God put a mark on Cain, and after he had killed Abel, so that no one should kill him at sight. God gave the sign of the rainbow as a sign of the covenant, so that the waters would never become a flood to destroy all mortal beings. In the book of Exodus, God empowered Moses with many signs when Moses had to present himself before Pharaoh in a bid to ask him to let go of the Israelites. In the book of Numbers, 250 men were consumed by a fire from the Lord after they had unworthily offered incense to God. The book of Judges, God gave a sign to Gideon when he asked for it humbly as a confirmation in his entrusted task. The first book of Samuel, God gave a sign at King Saul's anointing. However, in today's gospel, we find that when the Pharisees and the scribes demand a sign, Jesus does not yield to it. What was the reason? The demand of the Pharisees and the scribes was a demand for a sign, not in humility or to really cast off any doubt. Rather, this was a demand for a sign that exposed their obstinacy to remain in unbelief. In fact, Jesus sees through their insincerity. He sees through the fact that they were with wax, the wax of deceit, falsity, and deception. And this their wax of trickery began to melt in the presence of Jesus, the powerful light. Therefore, Jesus come down heavily on them and says, "An evil and adulterous generation seeks a sign." Note the two strong words that Jesus uses. Evil, pointing to a wicked heart that sought destruction and spoiling the lives of others. Adulterous, pointing to an unfaithful heart that reduces relation to a mere pragmatic nature and was characterized by cheating and disloyalty. Is my life also characterized by constantly wanting only signs from God? I expect immediate answer to all my prayers in the way I want. I always want some miracles as I choose to keep the light of my faith burning. I get depressed and feel totally lost when I do not get the signs that I expected in life. I witness a lot of wondrous deeds around me, but still I remain obstinate in my unbelief. Is my Christian life only a sign-seeking one, or is my Christian life rather a savior-seeking one? Am I obsessed with wanting only miracles, or am I rather passionate and zealous about the Master? Jesus invites us to be sincere, without wax. In his bright presence, all wax of duplicity and hypocrisy will melt. In his glowing light, all wax of dishonesty and deception will dissolve. In today's first reading, Prophet Micah beautifully echoes the mind of the Lord when he proclaims, "He has showed you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God." May we be closer to Jesus, the great Son, and live our Christian life in sincerity, in zealous, and with deeper passion for the Son of God. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gift of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and our Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people. He stretched out his hands as to endure his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Nicholas, our Bishop, Antoine, his brother in Christ, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints, and Bernadette, and who have pleased you throughout the age, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Behold, I stand at the door and knock, says the Lord. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door to me, I will enter his house and dine with him, and he with me. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Et c'est.
Ouais, ça, non.